Before diving into the magical world of porting phone numbers, Zoom recommends that you get a customer service record or CSR document from your current phone service provider. This industry standard document details your phone numbers and the information tied to those phone numbers. The likelihood of the port being accepted increases if you have this information in advance. To start the porting process in the Zoom web portal, along the left navigation under Admin, click to expand Phone System Management and select Phone Numbers. In the sub-navigation, click Ported, and then click on Port Numbers. Enter the phone numbers you wish to transfer here, with area codes, separated by a comma. You can simultaneously port up to 100 phone numbers with any single carrier at a given time. So if you have 20 phone numbers to transfer from a single carrier, enter them all together and not in separate waves. Click Check Portability once you have your phone numbers entered. The current underlying carrier responsible for the phone number will display below. If the name here is different from what you expected, don't be concerned. It is commonplace for phone service carriers to often resell underlying services. Note that this portability check does not work with toll-free numbers, but the Zoom phone team is ready to assist. When ready, click Next to continue. This next optional step allows you to automate the porting process to a degree. When porting over a phone number, you can have the ported number automatically replace an existing number within your account, helping to streamline the process and limit potential downtime. Enter a phone number to replace if desired, and when ready, click Next to continue. The final step to port a number over is to sign a letter of agency, or LOA. This form helps prove your ownership of the phone numbers you intend to port over to Zoom. If you have multiple carriers listed here, you will need to submit multiple LOAs, as the information for each account is unique. Mentioned at the beginning of this video, the Customer Service Record, or CSR document, will now come in handy. The information outlined on your CSR will help make this process much easier. One important field is the billing telephone number. This information should match the phone number provided on the CSR document and could be one of the numbers you are porting. The billing telephone number will not be the carrier's phone number, and it cannot be a toll-free number either. Another important field is the customer request date, or CRD. This date is purely a target date and might not be feasible depending on multiple factors. Leave this field blank only if you want the soonest date possible to be your target port date, which could be the next business day. Choose this date wisely to avoid any interruptions to your users. With the information entered, check the two boxes at the bottom of the form and click Submit. The numbers you are seeking to port, the order's status, and other information is displayed. Zoom will now submit a request to your current service provider using this information to begin the phone number porting process. Once the porting process is complete, the numbers will appear in either the assigned or unassigned subsections.